Hello everyone, welcome to Fiaura, and this is the T-72 in PvE mode! Now my biggest advice to PvE mode players, load the heat! You're going to run into so many light tanks and AFVs, it's totally worth just blasting them with the heat shells. And weasels need to die horrible screaming deaths, like that. Incoming arty. Ow. How did it... I stopped to fire and it managed to predict that I was going to move forward. Or it sporadically just fired and happened to hit with random luck. Either way, artillery smacked me in the head. My face. In the meantime, we are driving up. And I am maneuvering away from the ravine over there for the reason of protecting me from being shot from the other side. And there's another weasel. Die in a fire! You guys can tell, I hate weasels. Seriously, they're terrible, awful vehicles. Not really, they're awesome and amazing and destructive as hell. I need to die! When they are not on your team, you kill them first. Rule of thumb. Hello, Mr. Stingray. I'm gonna take like 500 hit points off of you. Yeah, the upgraded heat shell is so much better. I can't wait till they give us the servers 24 hours and actually fix some of the bugs, which I'm gonna highlight in today and tomorrow's video. There will be bugs highlighted. Obsidian, please pay attention. Alright, so that is an enemy artillery. That is never good. Also, enemies come in 5 classifications, for those who don't know. They come in Fragile, which is the lowest. Salvage, which is the second lowest. Standard, which doesn't have any moniker next to it. It just says the name of the tank. Upgraded, and Superior. You really want to kill the Superior ones very quickly. And this T-64 is getting something through the side of his turret. Called Fin Stabilized Heat Round. That's the weird one. The Soviet round, the heat rounds are fin stabilized in addition to the Sabo rounds being fin stabilized. So shouldn't the Soviet rounds therefore be more accurate? Just a thought. So the 64 terminates that Sheridan. I take aim at this Stingray and smack! Minimum damage roll! However, this poor guy gets away. But that poor guy at full health. Nope! The advantage to the Soviet main battle tanks. If you hit something with a heat shell and it pins, they're having all sorts of bad days. The gun is only 5mm bigger, but does a massive amount more damage. I really think the damage should be toned down, and the armor of the T-series of tanks toned up. That's me. That's my opinion. I understand that my opinion doesn't represent everybody, but that's really what I think. I think the damage of the T-series shells should be toned down a bit, and the armor of the tanks should be toned up. Yeah, I know we need to break that black market truck, but I'm more focused on the fact that there are still tanks alive and they need to die. And that somebody tagged the point and made these guys spawn, which, you know, makes our life a little easier. Now I turn around to deal with this, and I think somebody else shoots it first. Yep, Leopard got it. So I'm kind of wondering where that other truck is. And looking around, can't seem to locate it. When I say, you know what, I'm going to go in the ditch after it. Why not? You really want to get, I mean, it doesn't pay a lot more, but you really want to get those secondary objectives. And I've heard tale that tier 6, 7, and 8 tanks actually can't make money in PvE. Obsidian, I spend 20 to 30 minutes running through 3 PvE missions. Oh my god, BMD. Hold on 1 second. Hold that thought. You? Heat shell. Yeah, heat shell all day long, guys. I will go through almost all of these missions just spraying heat because it works. But anyway, Obsidian, the PvE missions need to be worth my time. They are the funnest aspect of your game. I've said this in the previous video. They really, truly are. Goodbye, Black Market Truck. I guess Black Market Explosives don't react well to heat rounds. I mean, that might just be my theory. But in the meantime, yeah, I really think that they should make PvE and PvP worth the same amount. Because it should really encourage a completely different demographic that Wargaming and Worth and Gaijin haven't touched, which is pure PvE mode combat. That would be demographic that your two nearest competitors haven't even focused. So we've completed this mission. I do believe you guys have seen this one before, but now we're going to get into the one that I lost. And I didn't deflect 10 enemy shots as my challenge. I didn't get shot at! And the one I did get shot at penetrated. So here's Calvary. Good advice. Because all the armor on the tank's on the front. I think they need to increase the side armor some, because some of the side penetrations are obscene. Also, Obsidian, there is an error on your T-Series tanks. The side skirts... Yeah, I've been playing... What I'm typing right now, I've been playing the same missions repeatedly, and then finally got this mission again and was happy. But the side skirts on your T-Series tanks... What I'm talking about, if you guys look on these tanks, next to the tank you'll see these long skirts that where the tracks are, not where the hull is, but like you can see the dividing line between the hull and the side skirts that go over the tracks. If these side skirts get penetrated, you take damage. That's not right. That's not the body of the tank. That should count as spaced armor, but instead you actually take damage from it. Ow. Mr. Stingray, I do not appreciate your shenaniganry. Oh my god, I rolled lower than 499. Oh wait, I'm firing Sabo. Yeah, I forgot to switch to heat. And I got pinned on the turret. Both of those shots were through the front of my turret. The gun mantles are not modeled. They need to be modeled. If somebody comes by and says, well, we're not modeling them because we want to give false weak points. MBTs already have too many weak points as is. Do not take away the one feature of being in an MBT, and that's your frickin' armor that it really has. Please, model the gun mantles. Goodbye, Mr. AMX. Hello, BMP. Now, I've done some complaining. That's because there are bugs, and that bug by far is the most jarring one of them all. Being in a main battle tank, hull down, and you're getting penetrated through the front of the turret. Actually, the odd part is, if they shoot your gun, and it penetrates your gun, it does damage to your tank. And this thing, the Ramka 99 is just a demon. He's penetrating the front of my turret, by the way. Every one of those shots is penetrating the non-modeled gun mantle. And that ricocheted. The ERA on that thing is absurdly good. Now, I never find out if this HE shell actually penetrated. Oh, it did. It barely did. Yeah. Armor on that thing is insane. Hello, Mr. Artillery. Well, you got double tapped. That was just mean. Climb up this hill. Climb, baby, climb. Also having a little trouble getting you guys some new footage because, I mean, it's really hard to earn new tanks. And this is testing. We shouldn't be testing the economy right now. A lot of us are agreeing we should not be grinding to test your game. Because a lot of the upper tier tanks just aren't getting tested because we can't get them. And, yeah, I don't know if I can actually see that Stingray or not. I'm just assuming I can't because there's no vehicle outline. But that's something that has been shown. And that shot got made. That shot failed. Apparently his tracks actually ate the heat round. However, that time, I fired right through the spaced armor on the side of the tank and penetrated and killed him. That extra spaced armor plate didn't help him at all. Yeah. You can see why people would get burned out with this game. I'm having fun in PvE. Now, I am doing some complaining here, but that's because... I mean... I have not had the most fun experience with Armored Warfare the past couple days because I've started to get to that point where I'm grinding to get tanks to show you guys new tanks, and I'm just fighting the game more than I am the enemies. Hi, BMP3. Goodbye, BMP3. Oh my god, they spawned. Eat it. I'm just backing up, but that guy hit the front of my turret, did some damage somehow, and yeah, I'm not quite sure what's going on there, but that was the front of my turret, and that shouldn't ever take damage. Hello, Patton. Goodbye, Patton. Let's just fling a heat round right into your side. By the way, you guys saw where that was pointed. I think that should have been eaten by the tracks and was not. I think one of the problems we're having here is if it penetrates an external module, it's counting as penetrating the entire vehicle. Yeah, Obsidian, I'm pointing out your bugs, while at the same time having a good time doing it. Oh my god, they spawn more! Okay, let them have it. Ooh! Ooh, god! That wasn't even... I think I just committed a war crime. That poor BMP3. I really think I just committed a war crime there. Oh, hello, Leopard. Bye, Leopard. And the PAC-90, who's running away. I don't understand that one. I really don't. But okay. Luckiest PAC-90 ever. But he's taken care of by our Leopard. Okay, now that I've wrought devastation, I'm spotted. Oh, it's the running away fragile BMP3. Going for the last going for this SAM site down here. Because we only have about 3 minutes to take those out. And again, every piece of reputation and credit we can possibly earn from these PvE missions, I am trying to earn just because they take up a lot of time. That's one of the reasons why I seriously think... Oh, by the way, I'm going mountain climbing. It's one of the reasons I seriously think that we should be getting paid as much for PvE as PvP, because these take time. And... I could run three PvP missions in the time it takes to run one PvE mission. And just rush forward, firing shots, get off two or three penetrations, and make more credits and reputation that way. Getting terrible stats, doing a terrible job, than anything else. I mean, right now the game really just doesn't pay out for doing a really good job. It does mean fewer battles... But if you were to say grinding 5 or 6 different tank lines, I really think it would just be easy just to jump into a PvP mission, drive forward shooting, and then when you die, jump in another tank. Identify. May not result in the best stats, but it is possible. Goodbye, SAM site. Oh, M60 Starship. I'm gonna... Aww! Ruin my fun, Leopard. Also, that fall. That fall did not hurt me. Seriously? Like, I literally hit the ground almost like this and took no damage. But then I have, like, my Sheridan do this number. Not actually, like, go down any further than it started and take 400 points of damage. Your ram and your fall damage probably need some looking at. Just saying. Dead tanks everywhere. Ugh. Total enemies on this mission. 11, 7, 2, 6, and 5 adds up to 31 enemy tanks. Artillery, AFVs, light tanks, and main battle tanks all included. That was a fight. Now we're going to move on to the cap. We're going to cover each other's backs because we don't know if there's going to spawn anymore. I like these longer missions, by the way. That face may be one of frustration, but I actually like these longer missions. Obsidian, longer missions. Do them. Make these missions really in-depth and really make you consider choices. And I'm not quite sure why the water tanks are lighting up with white rings, because that's what the SAMs light up with to tell us to shoot them. So I just shot one to see what would happen, and nothing. But yeah, they have these little... They have like the same coating around them that the secondary targets have. Thankfully, nothing else spawns. Also, I would definitely recommend not bringing artillery. I'm going to have a video later this week that's going to show you why I recommend not bringing artillery to PvE missions, because I brought one! And let's just say... reasons and stuff. So mission complete. The Leper 1's keeping up with me on damage, but... is not keeping up with me on kills. And I did not actually know that if I clicked the mouse, it would actually shoot. So I shot the leopard. The battle's over. When the end cutscene plays, all tanks should stop moving and all ability to fire should be ended. That's my opinion. But when NPCs actually kill tanks and we can't fight back, that's not really fair. Anyway. So now we have Umbrella. This is on hard mode. I want to see Insane, because Insane actually looks like it might be fun with the amount of fun I'm having on hard mode. I also really want to get together like a team of five people and just go hard mode, hardcore PvE for like a day. And just switch between all the different tanks we have. And I warn everybody, this is going to be brutal. Conserve your hit points. Because it's going to be brutal. And I go ahead and select a heat shell because... more than likely, I'm going to be able to pen stuff with my heat rounds. So far, it's worked out pretty well for me. Why shouldn't it continue to work out? So it's raining and pouring and stuff is still not quite rendering very quickly. And I see I believe that's a Patton, and I don't really have a shot. Oh god, artillery. Oh god, starship. Hi, starship. I'm going to shoot you. Hope you don't mind. That's an Abrams. There we go. I don't have outlines right now. That is a very big problem during PvE. The outlines just sometimes disappear. Okay, Abrams is dealt with. I don't have a kill yet. I'm gonna have to fix this. I am the lead tank, because I do have the most armor. Our Artie back there, though, does not need to be sitting still. He needs to move up with us, because if something spawns back there, never mind, he's dead. He's getting jumped by an AMX 10P, pack 90 right now, and he's gone. No! You will not crest the hill in front of T-72. T-72 will deny this. Now T-72 will be ballsy as hell. And line up to do something crazy, because I have no gun depression. Get the gun down and terminate. And back up. Now, I have learned that right now, since I don't have a gun mantle, which, Obsidian, you need to fix that. That is not something main battle tanks should have, is no gun mantle. I have learned to start turning my turret away from everyone at a, like, 10-degree angle. Between shots, so that they can't penetrate my gun mantle. That doesn't exist. Goodbye, Chieftain. Oof. T-64 behind me is taking a beating. That T-64 is dead. But then the worst thing in the world is about to happen. We haven't finished clearing the initial enemies. And our Leopard 1, oh, look at his course. Oh no, he doesn't get on it yet. Yeah, I'm screaming, don't touch the point. We haven't cleared the enemies. It's going to spawn a lot of shit. I want to make sure we get our secondary objective done and that we've cleared everything that's currently spawned. Such as those artillery that were shooting at us. Hello. Goodbye. Appears as though the M109 walked in the door and walked back out. Now I've been spotted. Oh. Is that so, Mr. Pac-90? Who I am going to have to shoot on pure instinct and motion through the bushes. I really think if not for the fact that I keep having to, like, aim and just look for a tank instead of looking for the outline, I would be doing a little better in PvE right now. Not streaming. Recording, Mr. Kilroy McJoy. As promised, it's not the weekend anymore, but it did make it up. Just took me some time to get to it. Now, I know to patrol the entire area and make sure that everything is dead. Because the last thing you want to do is start capping and then find out, oh, wait, we missed some tanks and they're spawning on top of that. Our AMX-10P is pretty beat up. I think the Leopard is also not in very good shape right now. We've lost our T-64 and our Arty, who foolishly sat at the spawn point. And I know that there is, I'm not sure if this is a bug obsidian, but I think I'm about to find a bunch of enemies. There's this place back here where the enemies keep seeming to gather and then not move out of until you get on cap. And it's kind of something that I don't know if it's a bug or intentional, but yeah. Yeah, right there. Look at that. There's three tanks in there. That was through the front of my turret. That actually hit my gun. My gun. And it did full damage to my tank. That broke my gun. Which takes me a second to realize, oh, my gun is completely broken. And at this point, I just go, screw it, ramming speed. Ram it, ram it, ram it. That was through the front of the turret again. And all badassery must break out. So yeah, that's where we are right now. There's enemies still coming at us. This is not a good place to be. Matter of fact, this was never a good place to be. But as you can imagine, we're fighting back. We're doing our best. And hopefully, that's going to be enough. The AMX-10P tags the point. And then the T-64A spawn, and then they spawn. And instead of pulling back, he rushes into them. His main battle tanks are nowhere near him, which is not good. Just cost him his life. I wanted to tell him to get out of there sooner. Ah, I missed that shot. Crap. Well, the Leopard made up for it. Now we've got all of these enemies to deal with, and they are coming out at us like never before. Oh my god, low roll! No, RNG, no! And there's an Abrams! It may be fragile, but it is an Abrams, which deflects my heat round rather easily. So we're gonna switch to Sabos. He's taking fire from the leopard. I put a sabo in him. Come on, leopard, finish off that Abrams. There we go. We got the big threat out. T-64 over here. We're not sure what he's doing. I got a 72 behind me. Yeah, that's why I ducked into there for cover. Just to see, you know, where everything was coming from before I moved out to engage. Still got sabos loaded. Because I want the guaranteed damage now. Their T-72 is an equal tier. Even if he is fragile, he's still equal tier. That penetrated. I'm surprised that penetrated. But then again, I remember, oh right, my side skirts, if they're penetrated, actually count as penetrating my hull. You can see the problem. High angle, those applique side skirts are actually inhibiting the tank a lot more than helping it now. I shot through the front of his turret, like flat out, just straight through the front of his turret. So something is definitely wrong with the Soviet tank models. I can honestly say that one. I'm not sure what, but something is definitely wrong. Hello. Goodbye. I really don't like those tank destroyers. I really, really don't like those tank destroyers. And now after this brutal slugfest... Oh, crap. Another T-72. Alright, there's a pen. Back up, back up, back up. Damn it, no. If I could shoot through the truck. If I had an outline. If I had an outline. What? It broke a track. Passed through, hit the other track, but didn't actually hurt the tank. I hit him. Pen. He just did 400 damage. For an NPC, that's a hell of a lot. And killed me. Might I add... the front of the turret. And he was the last enemy. He was the last enemy. That missed shot. That unable to shoot through the truck. And that track shot cost us everything. Actually lost money here. As you guys will see, I made 52. I'm going to get through these other notifications, which there's a lot of. I made 52. I spent 48, so I only made like 10 grand in money. Yeah. Brutal, brutal match. I hope you guys enjoyed. I do have a T-72 on hard mode that is successful, and we will be taking a look at it later. But in the meantime, this is Fiaura officially signing out for right now, and I will see you in the next video, guys. Bye-bye.
Thank y'all for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and if you did, why not click the like button? It would really help the channel and let me know that you're enjoying my content. Want to see more content? There's a subscribe icon right there so you know when I put up videos. I would appreciate it also if you helped grow this channel's community. So share this with your friends or just put it up on Facebook. Want to help Fiaura out directly? There are three ways you can do this. One is the Patreon page, which all the investment towards I put right back into the channel through